then his religion is the religion of all of mankind. And therefore there can be only one true religion. And so we reject from this platform the claim that all religions are true. And it is a measure of tolerance that you accept that they are all true. We reject that because he is the imam of all of mankind. And therefore there is only one true religion. And it is the religion of Abraham. The Quran addresses Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam and declares to him, ثُمَّ أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ, and then we reveal to thee, O Muhammad alayhi salatu wa sallam, and اتَّبِعَ مِلَّةَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ حَنِيفًا. You must follow the religion of Abraham alayhi salam. So now we know that Abraham alayhi salam is brought to the Holy Land and settled in the Holy Land. And there are blessings in this Holy Land for all of mankind, indicating for all of mankind who follow the religion of Abraham, the one true religion. The Quran then takes up the subject many years later, after the Israelite people had been taken to Egypt and had lived there for some few centuries and had been then enslaved in Egypt by the pharaohs. And we don't have the time to give you that story, that interesting story tonight. And then Allah raised a man and commissioned him to go and struggle to deliver the Israelite people out of slavery in Egypt. This is the Prophet Moses, alayhi salam. And he came with the truth, and Pharaoh rejected it. He came with signs from Allah. Pharaoh rejected them. He warned him. Pharaoh disregarded the warning. Pharaoh persisted in his arrogant disdain for the truth which had come with Moses, alayhi salam, and clung to his own theory that he was the truth, and that his authority is the supreme authority, and that his law is the highest law. Sounds familiar today, doesn't it? And then when the moment came for the final showdown, and Allah ordered Moses, alayhi salam, and the Israelite people to flee, and then Pharaoh pursued them. And now the Israelite people, to use that quaint English expression, when they're almost to the sea, they were between the devil and the deep blue sea. Pharaoh and his army behind, and the deep blue sea in front of them. And so the enemy must have been rubbing his hands. We've cornered them now. We're going to finish them now. And this upstart who dares to challenge us, we who are drunk with power, we're going to finish them now. But Allah plans his plans when they plan their plans. And when Moses, alayhi salam, reached the water, then Allah ordered him, strike the water with your rod. And then Allah parted the sea. If he could do that yesterday, guess what he can do tomorrow? وَإِذْ فَرَقْنَا بِكُمُ الْبَحْرِ, we parted for you the sea. فَأَنْجَيْنَاكُمْ, and we delivered you to safety. وَأَغْرَقْنَا آلَ فِرْعَوْنَ, and that arrogant upstart out there who dares to challenge Allah's sovereignty and Allah's supreme authority and Allah's law is the highest law, we destroyed it. وَأَنْتُمْ تَنْزُرُونَ, And it happened before your very eyes. And so now they are in Sinai, not the hospital in Manhattan. The desert. And then Moses goes up the mountain. Allah calls him up the mountain. Alayhi salam. And there he receives the Torah. But it came down, the beginning of the Ten Commandments in stone tablets. And then he came back down, and of course you know the story about the golden calf and so on. And then Moses, alayhi salam, he now gives the command to Banu Israel. He says, and this is Surah Al-Ma'idah, يَا قَوْمِ ادْخُلُوا الْأَرْضَ الْمُقَدَّسَةَ الَّتِي كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ إِلَىٰ أَخِرِ الْآيَةِ. O my people, come on, let us fight, let us enter, let us take control of the holy land which Allah gave to you. If this is in the Quran, how come we don't hear them talking about it? How come the New York Times does not spread it on a full page? Sounds suspicious, doesn't it? There is a reason why they would not touch the Quran. Come on, let us enter and take control of the holy land which Allah gave to you. This is Surah Al-Ma'idah. But when they were given this command, and they came to learn that the people who lived in that land were a powerful people, Goliath, for example, they didn't have a stomach to fight. So they responded to their prophet and said to him, oh no, we're not going. You and your Lord, both of you go and fight, we will stay right here. It is difficult for us to conceive of a people behaving so shamelessly, so insultingly to the prophet who is their prophet and who is there in their midst, and to the Lord who has just parted the sea before their very eyes to deliver them to safety. It was insulting behavior. And the Quran teaches us that Allah responded. What did he do? He banned their entry into the Holy Land for how long? 40 years. But wait a minute. The land had been given to them. But now they are banned from entering the Holy Land. So it seems as though the grant of the land was not unconditional. It seems as though the grant of the land was conditional. And when they violated the condition, he denied them the land. And so they are debarred for 40 years. And then Allah expresses his anger in the Quran. And he speaks to the heart of his prophet, Musa alayhi salam, Moses. And he says to him, فَلَا تَأْسَ عَلَى الْقَوْمِ الْفَاسِقِينَ. Do not grieve over these sinful, wicked people. I remember, must have been a rabbi, I don't know, from Los Angeles, who started engaging me in emails back and forth on this subject. And then I got an email, he said, don't you have any pity for us? So I replied with the Quran, where Allah himself said to his prophet, do not grieve over a people who have acted in this manifestly sinful way. After the 40 years in the desert, and they all died in the desert, including Moses, alayhi salam. Then the next generation, after 40 years, they were allowed to enter into the Holy Land. And then they fought under Joshua, for example. And then under David, alayhi salam, they were able to consolidate themselves as a kingdom. And he, the prophet, is also a king. We have a prophet king. He is the founder of the state of Israel. It is an Islamic state because his religion is Islam, meaning a religion of submission to Allah as sovereign, a religion of submission to Allah's authority as supreme.